Hey guys, Wild for Games here. Today I want to show you something that's been bugging me for quite a while. I wanted to know if it was possible to recover deleted or accidentally deleted DMs on Twitter. Well, after doing much research on Google, you're pretty much going to find the same two answers over and over. Answer number one is basically if you have your email associated with your Twitter account, it'll always send you an email letting you know that you received a message. So you can always refer back to those. But for me, I actually don't have my email hooked up to my Twitter. So you're left with option number two, which is you can always ask the person that you're sending messages to actually screen cap and send them back to you. Well, there's a problem with that. What if you're not on good terms with that person or they just straight up don't like you? Well, you're pretty much screwed from that point. These weren't acceptable answers for me, so I kind of went on a scourge to find out if I could find my answer. Well, after searching through about 100 web pages there, I kind of found a thread of a thread of a thread that led me to a software program that somebody had actually developed, and it's called Snapbird. I will put the link in the description below if you guys haven't referred to it. What you basically do is go up to the top right corner, and it's going to ask you to authenticate up here. I already have done so. It's free to use. It'll just ask you if it's okay to access your Twitter account. You'd basically just click yes. It'll log in for about 30 seconds. When you're logged in, it'll actually say your screen name up here. For me, it's Wild for Games. And then it's going to ask you what you would like to search. Snapbird can actually search quite a few things, but for today's tutorial, we're going to actually show you the messages. The messages are the last two, direct that were sent to you and direct ones that were received. Today, I'm just going to show you the direct. You can fuss around with the other one if you so like to. All you do is select direct and then go to search. It's going to take about anywhere from 10 to 15 seconds to pull the first 100 messages received. Once it's pulled in all the search messages, it'll basically lay them out here. And this way, you can refer back to them of who was sent to, when, and what the messages said. Now, you can pull these all out if you need to and see what you need to, but it's going to show you all the messages that were sent back and forth between all the different users. Most of mine are just fun things sent back and forth for my painting or just funny pictures that I send to my friends. Now, if it's something beyond 100, you can go all the way to the bottom here and it'll ask you to search 100 more. Now, there's only limitations. From what I can find on the API through Twitter, that'll only pull down 200 messages. There are some software programs out there that say that'll pull out more than 200. I kind of feel like those are fraud programs because even Twitter's API says they only give access for about 200 messages grand total. So be very wary because it says you can buy for upgrades. I don't know if that's true or not. I'm just going off what I've seen in other people's messages and through Twitter's API board. Now, there is one more program out there that you guys can use. If you want this all put out on a spreadsheet, another program that I was able to find is called tweetdownload.net. I will also put this in the description below if you guys like to use this. It basically is the same thing as Snapbird. However, it basically puts everything in an Excel spreadsheet for you, and it gives you a little more detail of when things were actually sent in the time frame they were sent. Snapbird will give you the date, but Tweet download will give you the date and time. Now, the problem with tweet download is it'll only work on a character base. If your message was 1,000 characters long, it can only display about 250 characters before the message is cut off on the Excel spreadsheet. So you may want to refer back to Snapbird if it's something under 200. This is just a quick tutorial that I wanted to show you guys. I know a lot of people have been asking this question on Twitter and Reddit, so I just want to show you guys how it's done. Thanks for watching, and if you guys like this video, make sure you share it and give it a nice like, and you can also follow me on all of my social platforms, which I'll put on the description below. Have a good one.